Yo, what's up guys? I am back. I just used one of my insights because I wanted to play co-op. And what we're going to do now is we're going to go and kill Father Gascoigne, which is the second boss in Bloodborne. So I will show you how to kill him easy and quickly. But in the meantime, we're just going to make our way through the boss. And then hopefully I'll get some people that will kill some enemies and get me some Molotov cocktails, which would be quite nice. Or some okay, so basically I've got 2 insight and I'm aiming to get to 10, so I can buy the small resonant bell so I can actually be in someone's game and help them, and hopefully it doesn't cost, because if it all costs, be pretty damn annoying. So, as what's good is that basically the small resonant bell. Shit, they're coming. The small resonant bell will last until you die, which will be quite nice. So basically, just the bell will keep ringing until as long as you're alive. You'll just have people going and dying. So it's quite good the way it's worked. Go, game done. Alright, let's see how loud this is. I'm trying to tune in my my voice with the thing. Basically what I'm gonna do, just let the fireball come. Kill the boot. Yes, I got one blood vial out of all of that. See, when you if you try to call it, it won't let you. Right, let's go. Father Gascoigne is actually really close. It's not actually that far. I thought, he's miles away. Wow, what the hell was that? Dead, nice. I've got 2 more vials, which is awesome. So we got here within 3 minutes, really. I want to see if the piggy spawns. Oh, discover the charm of a small resonant bell, which is what I'm after, because I want to freaking join this people game and help them. Oh, the pig just keeps spawning. That's actually quite good. That's actually quite good. That's back in Dead the Bulky. I don't actually have any Molotovs, which is annoying. I was hoping to bring some Molotovs. I completely forgot. I should have, before I started recording, I should have really, done it. Alright, what are they gonna do? Blood vials and blood vials. Oh, great. Father Gascoigne. Well, I'm not gonna let us yet. Hold on guys, the camera's all gonna go off slightly. I'm just gonna invite this dude to the chat pod and hopefully he's English. Alright, back in 2 seconds, boys. Right. Hopefully you can still hear me, but sorry if I can't. If you can't see it, I've literally been seconds, mate. Hello. How are you? That's good. I've only been playing it for like 4.5 hours. I've been recording me playing. I have, obviously, because I'm a YouTuber, so I've had to like play on and off just because I have to sort of videos out. And I haven't died yet in this game. Oh, no, actually, no, that's a lie. I've died once. That didn't count, to be fair, because freaking at the beginning of those big guys, I freaking got cornered in a freaking sandbag. This was so annoying. I said, you know that tutorial guy at the beginning? Yeah. Did he die? Hold on, I'll die. Hold on, we kill this guy. Hold on, let me. Oh, did you? Oh, no, mate. I've been, the amount of people I've seen on YouTube died from that thing. They always go, oh, let's just fist him. A freaking I wanted to be one of the first people like to actually kill it with bare fists, so I fucking bare fisted him. It was well easy both, and people were like, wow. And then I just basically just I was trying to figure out, do you have to die in order to go down that hunter's dream? But I obviously I watched a bit of gameplay. I've not watched too much, and there was a lamp obviously ahead up the ladder, so I thought, well, see, will it recognize I've been to Hunter's Doom, or will I have to die in order to unlock the area? And I could have just, you know, went fisting everything. It was really painful, so I just freaking had to get the guy near the ladder. I had to get the guy near the ladder away, so I could obviously pull the lever down and then obviously run back and climb up. It's just, yeah, I've only died once. Huh. Yeah. Yeah, I've not unlocked that yet because I've not played enough of the game. I've only got 2 insight and I'm trying to get to 10 so I can buy the invaded thing. So yeah, you get one from counting and then you get 3, 4. Yeah, I know a lot about this game. I'm a Dark Souls 2 master. I've platinumed it, and I'm like the best at it. So that's why I'm quite good at this game, because obviously it's very similar. Huh. Yeah. I'm level. Hi. Level 17. I started at level 10 when I made this character, and I'm level 17 because I always like to overpower myself before I go to ever. Because obviously, the way I'd play the game is that obviously Dark Souls 2, I had the strategy guide, and the strategy guide would tell me what level they recommended you to be in each era. So basically, the first era was 20. So what I would always do is get to 25, so you're 5 levels higher than you should be, and then it's obviously slightly easier. So obviously, I went to the shop today, and they didn't have any strategy guides in because it was a delay into the country. So it's a lot because I really wanted to play the game with the strategy guide, but yeah, I'm just I want to get a few Molotovs for the Father Gascoigne bell, but I've not got any. What I think they should do, allow is that if I want to go to the Hunter's Dream, you should both be able to go, but we can't. So I have to keep wasting my insights. Huh. What is annoying. Yeah. It's okay. Yeah. I wouldn't mind if you turn your volume up slightly if you could. If you can, of course, only slightly, though. All right. Yeah. I got. Yeah. I'm just trying to get some Molotovs. I need to get at least five Molotovs. What's it called? What weapon do you use? Fuck's sake! Oh, nice. What class did he choose? What? Really? How come? How come? How come you chose that? Yeah, I've got. What have I got? I've got a Hunter's Axe. Yeah, I'm just going for one build. That's why if I go for one build character and just max up all the stats that way, you know. Because I chose the Misky Toast thing, which basically like average, so you can decide whatever path you want. Because I'm obviously Dark Souls 2, it was easy. I was a sorcerer and I literally had 99 intelligence and I was the best at PvP, man. I was literally OP as fuck. But obviously this game doesn't have that, so I'm gonna, you know, what choose. I really wanted to have a sorcerer kind of top. Yeah. Item, wait a second. I'm like in the sewers, mate. Just trying to. I forgot. I need to go back to the beginning actually to get some Molotovs. To be fair. I've got maxed out, I think, out 20. I just want to get some Molotovs before we go and do five, I guess. So. Yeah, that's. That's a bit of a bummer, that is, mate. Yeah, I don't see a point of why would you make different character builds if, you know, at some point you're gonna get all your stats to like max, so it's kind of pointless in my opinion. What do you mean the next playthrough? What do you mean by that? What, do the different characters look different, or? Yeah, no, you can make different NPCs from the knocking on doors to the cathedral ward. Yeah. Huh. I don't think it would. I think it'd just be characters. I think different characters. I'm depending on Covenants. Yeah, the first Covenants is that lady. What's her name? Where am I going? I'm going the wrong way. So I don't know what her name is. That lady. That crow lady. Yeah, there's a lady. That's a crow. I think it's a lady or a man. I don't know. It's a crow person. It's basically. Once you get to. What boss was it? I'm going the wrong way. Where was that? Where did you see it the first time? The hell? Nice. What a second bridge. Verse, verse. Are you sure? Where are you? I did colour my bushes. I just colour them. What does he send the first time? Blah 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 blah. The next time she appears is once you kill the same boss, and then you have to kill a boss, and then she triggers at the Father Gascoigne battle, and then you have to kill the thing she's fighting, and then the third time she appears is the Cathedral Ward, the Grand Cathedral, I think it's called. So. You know, I know. Move, come on. I'm not moving. The NPC. Oh, one of your knights was waited. Huh. Nice, that's... I don't know, do you get items? Oh yeah, same to I. Huh. Yeah. I've got to get item over there, so that's over there. Where's he gone? How are you? Blood vial. Oh yeah. There's a guy. There's a guy over here. I remember now. Yeah, to the right. Yeah. Yeah, that just rang a bell now. Yeah. Yeah, I remember now. Yeah, there's a guy here, isn't there? But I don't know if I have to kill the second boss or something. Oh no, you have to kill, you have to go and kill the, fuck, what boss was it? The one before Vicar and Amelia, yeah. Yeah, one before that, the blood starved beast is what you gotta go and kill. Yeah, so once you've, I think it's either that boss or the Vicar and menu, the one after. I don't know, I think I'm pretty sure it's the fourth boss, I'm pretty sure, and then just basically, go to the lamp, which is the one after. Yeah, because if you try and transport to the Father Gascoigne, because obviously once you kill Father Gascoigne, there's a lamp there, it won't let you go there, which means she's there, so you have to go to one like either after or before, and then you obviously just go there, kill the person she's fighting, and then she'll give you a... Oh no, yeah, no, that's at the end. That's at the end. Once you finish all our things, you get a rune, yeah. Oh, yes, I got two bloodstone things, which is I need one more. Jeez, I'm dead. Fuck. I'm fine now, but fuck me, I was not prepared for those rats to come and invade me. Fuck me, another rat just appeared. Fuck. Nah, I never die. Right. That's good. Throwing knives. Huh. I'm not getting any Molotovs, which is really gay. I might actually go and go back to the beginning and farm those enemies at the beginning. Hopefully, they'll drop Molotovs easy. So. Yeah. I just got that from that lady after opening the shortcut. Huh. Yeah, after he gets half down to like 3/4, he goes, whoa, and he gets big. Yeah. Huh. Yeah. Oh yeah, I need to get some Molotovs. Do you have Molotovs? Nice, let me just get a few. I'm just going to save some. Because what I did with the cloak boss, the cloak piece, I literally just chucked loads of Molotov, stunned him, staggered him, stabbed him, and then just repeated up really. Oh, you killed these enemies. Huh. I got 2 blood vials. That's good. You pretty much killed all the enemies at the beginning. What's good, it's not timed like Dark Souls 2, where if you spend too long, then you're gonna get transported back. It's literally, we need to spend, we could literally just not do nothing but kill enemies. Okay. Yeah, and it would only expire if either I die or we kill a boss, which that will never happen. Oh, can it? Well, me dying will never. What? I've done each boss on my first attempt, so well, the first boss I've done. It's the only boss I've done so far. I've not died yet, so yeah. But Father Gaswin, oh, I discovered the chime of a small resonant bell, so we're now gonna get 3 people in now. Woohoo. can he come over to where I am? Just there's a lot of enemies. I'm at the starting area where you, the center bit, where the beginning, the tutorial part. Where are you? Oh, yeah. Huh. Nice. Just, I just want to try and get a few, where's this other, dude should spawn near me. So the small resonant bell, what does that cost insight or not? Because it'd be ridiculous if it did. The small resident bell, you know, if that's good, that's. So you could just farm that, then just keep it in your small resident bell, you know, help someone kill a boss, and then you'll get an insight. That's what I want to do. Yeah, there's this farming location on the. Oh, I don't know, it's at the old Yarmen. There's a farming spot where you just basically jump down his house and then you kill this electric guy, and then I don't know, I don't really watch the full video, but I watched a bit of it, and then basically just basically kill something else, and then basically you'll get about 3,000 souls per kill, which is like wow. And then you'll get like twin blade blood shards, and then you'll get an insight per one, so basically just repeat it. So I need to watch, once I get there, I'm not going to watch too much, because obviously I don't want to know what happens really. I just watched a hint of it, because obviously I didn't realise that was like halfway through the game. Huh. Oh, what? Yeah, once you get your thing, once you get your plus thing to 3 or 4, I think it's 3, yeah, you'll have to get the twin, blade swords, blade bloods. So what weapon have you got? I'll tell you what I've got. I've got the hunter axe to +1 and the Kirk hammer to +1. And then I've got the hunter pistol to +1. That's all I've done really. I need to get friggin' bloodstones. Oh, okay. No, it's not good, really. Yeah, that's good, that is. That's what I've got, yeah. No, wait. Well, I did have it. I don't know where it's gone now, but... Okay, but... No, yeah, I found it. I bought... No, the only one that got me is obviously the hammer. My phone's nearly dead. Oh, right, where is the other guy? Can he come towards me? Cause there's a bunch of enemies which I want you to help me kill so I can try and get Molotovs, because they'll drop Molotovs like nuts, mate. Dude, fuck. Because I keep treating this like Dark Souls 2, so I keep pressing the wrong button, which is really annoying. The amount of times, what I keep doing, I keep thinking triangles to switch weapons, but it's not, it's the freaking heal. So I keep draining my freaking... See, I'm just trying to get used to the controls. How about the starting area? Just trying to get some Molotovs, really. Yeah. Oh, there's a really good farming spot which I want to show you when we get there. It's basically at the... Oh, I killed those. Huh. Oh, someone else did? No, that was really nice. Oh, what was it? What I do like about this game is that you can customize your own dungeons, so it's not based around the full game. You can customize your own dungeons, so you can put like a chalice down and you can make it like easy, hard, or really hard, which is quite nice. And you'll get like different bosses, so yeah. You unlock your first chalice once you get to like the once you kill Rika and Amelia, you unlock your first, your chalice. Do you want to hear him? You might want to hear him. Yeah, what I do want to know is how do I make you... Obviously, if you accept my friend request, how do I make you join my game? Because obviously they said you can make for passwords. So what I want to figure out is how do you join my game? That's what I want to know. Because then, you know, if you ever die, then you can just obviously, you know... Yeah. Oh. Okay, we should test. Okay, accept my friend request. I will test it once we've done a Father Gascoigne boss, if you want. but actually, yeah. Okay. Right, I've got. How many souls have you got? I've got. I've not got many really. I spent on the 10,000 key thing to the Cathedral Ward, and I spent the. And I bought the Kirkhammer. Ah, oh, nice, nice. I've got like. 2006. Yeah. That's what I use. I had a couple, right, and they gave me 1,000 each. So I got given 4,000. It's like what? It was crazy, mate. This what one new you get. What on the what? Yeah. Huh. Oh yeah, because once you kill him, you can buy that from the. I'm not getting any Molotovs. It's really one way up. it's like Destiny. Stuff I don't want. Destiny. That's it. Fuck. Dude, I'm not. Yeah, I'm trying to kill all the enemies, just, you know, kind of, and if I don't get fucking Molotovs, then we'll just do the boss. It's easy anyway, so I'm not too bothered. I just would prefer going in with Molotovs, because Molotovs is my favourite thing. Because once, that's what you do, yeah, you just keep staggering, Gascoigne, and once you get to 3 quarters, just Molotov him until he dies. No. Or you could just do your thunder sacks and then just do the spin attack of this thing. I think was to keep everything that when he sort this way. I think that's all. You've killed all the enemies. Oh, right, wait, there's enemies over here, I think. No, it's the birds, isn't it? Yeah, the birds. Huh. Yeah, I'm just trying to work on leveling up all my stats. Like, just gone up by one on all my stats, really. So what I want to do is I want to get this character to 25 and all its stats, and then I'm going to do like another build with like the one that's got more blood tinge, and just work on blood tinge and arcane and see what the difference is, see if the damage is crap, or you know, just to test out. Yeah, that's the best weapon in the game is the well it's not the best weapon in the game, but it's the best weapon when you get to Cathedral Ward. It's basically you know when you spawn in on the lamp, yeah, and then there's the red guy behind you, he goes, "Oh, if you find anyone, please tell them to come to the Odin Chapel," you know that one. Yeah. Well, if you face him and you go left, and then there's a door to your right, and if you go up there and you got the elevator, there's this, you basically go, just follow the path, kill all the enemies, go up the level ladder, be another ladder, blah blah blah. And then you'll get like the holy sword, which is like badass. let's call the Ludwig holy sword. The Ludwig holy sword, which is what I want. Well, I just want to get every weapon to like max, just see its end stats, really. You know. So, right, let's, I've annoyed, I didn't get any Molotovs, which is, a bit of a bummer, man. Right. My chime should be active still, really. I don't want to risk doing a ringing again because I've only got two, but... Nice. I'll just wait in. So do you get... tell me if you get souls as well, because that'd be quite good for like a farming method. To, you know...